gone up for more?
I don't know what he's doing.
Yo, here we are again with this Sonic shit. Yo, I know y'all been waiting for me to drop some shit. I'm not gonna flow, y'all. How y'all doing today? This video right here is basically gonna wrap up everything with Sonic on this channel. As you know, I've done a lot of Let's Plays in the past, and I've done a lot of different videos regarding Sonic that have covered most of the series. But there's a few games that we have not looked at, I've not given my opinions on this channel. I've done it on Twitter. I guess that's sort of what's kept me from doing this kind of videos, because I already put my opinions out there on these games. As well as like that tier list video, I kind of already said where I think the games belong. So it's kind of hard for me to make this kind of video for y'all. But I feel like as far as the completion of this channel, this is why I'm doing it. So let's just jump right into it. Okay, so starting us off, I want this to be a really kind of brief thing. I don't want to take too much time on each game. So we're going to start off with the 8-bit games, mainly the main title and the Rush and the Drift games, my bad. So I really do like all the 8-bit games, whether I played them on Master System or Game Gear or even on SADX. Like I, for the most part, I like them all except for like Sky Patrol, Mean Bean Machine and Spinball, but I'm pretty positive towards each and every one of them for the most part. So starting us off, Sonic 1 8-bit. I really like both Sonic 1 and Sonic 2 8-bit for the same reason. It's because they play like Sonic 1. There's no spin dash, and the actual physics feel pretty comparable to its Genesis counterparts. Sonic 2 8-bit is basically Sonic 1.5 because there's still no Tails, but he's all over the game. It feels like Sonic 1, but with original stages. And that's basically what Sonic 1 is, too. It's just basically if you really like Sonic 1 and you want like new stages, it's a bit more difficult, but you know, it's still catered towards you. And I like these games for that. Plus, Sonic 1 8-bit, I really like... I used to, for some reason, it was just a thing I did, was play Sonic 1 8-bit on SADX a lot while it was raining and stuff. And that's just always the memory I carry with it, like going through Jungle Zone and it'd be raining outside. And, you know, it's just a fun rainy day game. Same with Sonic 2 8-bit once I got to that one. Same thing, like the bosses are hard. Like there's one thing I gotta knock them for, obviously it's the bosses. Because you know there's no rings, and I think Sonic 2 8-bit got like a ROM hack that puts rings in those stages. Hopefully one day Sonic 1 8-bit gets that as well, but I like these games for what they are. Sonic Chaos, I already covered this game on an LP, which is weird, it's my only 8-bit Sonic LP, I know that. But yeah, Sonic Chaos, I really don't have much to say about it. It is an improvement on the previous games, I think. Physics wise, definitely not. Like, but the actual, like, you get to play with Tails. It's a lot more easier. There's rings on the bosses. Pretty cool level design. Like, there's a lot of exploration in them. I like this game. My only problem with it is that Tails is a lot easier than Sonic. Don't ask me why it's like that, but the fact that you have to get all the emeralds to get to the last stage is kind of dumb to me. And that all the games kind of, the 8-bit games kind of play upon that. Like, you have to get all the emeralds before you can get to the end of these, to the last zone. Or you just get a bad ending. There's no, you have to start all over. It's just like that. It's fucking stupid. But Triple Trouble, man, I really like Triple Trouble. I think I'm really excited for that 16-bit one that's coming out, actually. Like, really excited for that because, I feel like this is the most 16-bit, besides, like, I guess, Pocket Adventure, like, in an 8-bit game is, like, a handheld Sonic game at the time, before the Advance games. I really like, everything about this game. Like, I really like Sunset Park Zone. I like all the stages. Like, there's even, like, what is it, Meta Jungle stage? Like, it has the same gimmicks as CD with the little bouncy things. Something cool about all the 8-bit games is just how they play upon CD. They're the only games to really acknowledge CD until, like, we got these newer games like Sonic 4 Episode 2, Mania, Generations. Like, CD was only referenced or even considered canon by these 8-bit games, and it's really cool. Even shared, like, some of the same soundtrack together. But I like everything about this game. Just the idea of Sonic having three different people coming after him, like Eggman, Knack, and Knuckles, just constantly antagonizing them. And then the game balls down really, like, cool. Like, the last zone. Yeah, I like how, like, the last zone and a half. I say half because, like, Knuckles is the last boss on that last stage. And then you have to fight Metal Sonic. You have to fight Knack. It basically just balls down, like, really crazy. And I love it. All right, Sonic Blast. Man, I don't really have much of an opinion on this game. But my general opinion is that, like, it looks pretty boring, I guess. Like, I played through it one time, and I don't really have an opinion on it. Like, the stage themes are really bland. I think what it is, they spent more time on the actual, importing of these graphics to this game rather than coming up with stage ideas. Because the stage ideas are just bland. Like, I don't really have an opinion. Basically, how would I describe this game? It basically feels like one of those, I guess what it reminds me of is, like, those Mortal Kombat games where, like, they put the graphics, like, you can see the actual arcade graphics on, like, a handheld, like, the Game Gear or the Amiga or something like that, like those handhelds. But then the game itself just really doesn't have much else going besides a visual thing. Like, but then, yeah, that's basically that. Yeah, alright, Sonic Labyrinth. I really like this game. I know people hate on it, but I think this game is a gem. It is one of the most unique Sonic games I've ever played. It just goes into that whole essence of Sega, like how they experimented with Sonic. People don't like this game because it's slow, because we, like, Sonic is at a walking pace all the time, but I think, like, I like to think of that as, like, that's the game penalizing you every single time. Like, every step you take is penalizing you. Like, the way that you go fast is you're supposed to be in a ball. You're supposed to be using your spin dash. That's the whole gimmick of the game. Even at the title screen, Sonic's in a fucking ball, just rolling back and forth. If you ever played, like, those little games at Walmart, like those little gift things you see at birthday parties and stuff, like with the little metal ball that you gotta put around in a maze, that's basically a labyrinth. That's what they call those things, labyrinths. Like, you're meant to be in a ball, and people don't really get that. I get that this game does get kind of difficult at times. Like, you only get, like, you get two hits for bosses. You can only get hit, like, once you get hit once, all your rings are gone, then you get hit again, you die. I understand that part of it, but the actual premise of the game and all that, I think this game is amazing. I think it's a lot better than 3D Blast. Like, just saying that right now, I'm not a big fan of 3D Blast. I like the soundtrack. I think it looks pretty cool. But, like, I think it's junk. If I have to be honest, like, maybe if the game didn't have flickies and stuff, then maybe. But overall, I'm not a big fan of 3D Blast. Sonic Drift 1 and 2. Man, I like Sonic Drift 2 a lot. Sonic Drift 1 is just basically, I'm glad it didn't come to America, first off. Like, it's basically pretty bland. You go through one cup of it, you basically played the entire game. Like, Like, I get, like, yeah, there is different layouts for stages on different cups, but I mean, it all feels the same. Like, you're just going left or right when you're driving. I don't know. So, like, the fact that it's the same stages over and over really doesn't interest me. And then there's just four characters on that game. Doesn't really interest me. Now, Sonic Drift 2 is a different story. Like, yeah, it kind of plays the same way, but it does introduce a lot of new mechanics and introduces items. Any enemies use items as well in this one. A lot of new original stages. Like, I really like that Balloon Panic stage. I hope at some point we, like, if there's a Mania 2 and they bring Emerald Hill Zone, I hope that this is one of the ideas that they take and do something with. Because it's basically Emerald Hill Zone, but with, like, balloons everywhere. I think that'd be a really cool, like, reimagining of the stage. Yeah, I like all the stages. Dude, I love the music. I think Ice Cap in that game has some of my favorite music. And there's just, like hidden things about it. And one of my favorite things between both of these games is that at the time there were only 6 emeralds. So it was, like, and there's 3 cups per game. And they all just, like it's just 6 cups, 6 emeralds. And I guess you can kind of put these games together, which, unfortunately, if Sonic Drift 1 had more stages, I think, like, it, you could package these games together better, and it'd be really cool. Sonic Spinball, man, I love this game. Like, I don't know, it's the general opinion on it, but, like, it's really cool. For the one of my favorite things that Sega of America did this game, and it's just such a weird game, like, Sonic doing the pinball thing and, like, the actual classic games. Like, it kind of blends both of what we know Sonic for and then, like, the actual pinball thing. Like, don't get me wrong, like, I guess Sonic, them wanting to do Sonic and pinball wasn't, like, just, what would I say, like, pushed in there. Like, they actually took a lot of time, putting the game together. It's a really concise game for what it is. Like, only 4 zones, really difficult, but when you finally beat it, it feels really damn good. That's all I gotta say about it. I really like all the zones, like, if you can get to them, of course, but I like all the zones. Especially, like, the last zone, what's it called, Showdown? Dude, it's probably some of the most fun I actually had with the Sonic game, like, getting to the end of it. I don't know why, but I really did enjoy going through that part of the game. Okay, so we did go through all of the Advance games and Battle and all, like, basically everything except for Sonic Pinball Party. Sonic Pinball Party, my opinions on it, I guess I like, what I like about it is that it's basically like Pokemon Pinball Ruby and Sapphire, to where it's, as a game, it's very faithful to Advance, like Sonic Advance itself. So it's a Sonic Advance pinball game. Out of all of the, out of all of the Sonic games out there, I probably want Advance for whatever reason. I don't know why it's like that. It's that game I really didn't ask for. But out of any of, like, Sonic's games, I think Advance probably would be the game I choose, looking back, as, like, the game to theme my pinball game behind. And it works better than I thought it would. Let's just say that. So, like, going through arcade mode, you have a lot of fun just, like, trying to get through each one, like, each zone and stuff. It has all the zones. Like, it wasn't until recent years I found out that there's actually a Super Sonic pinball. Like, there's the Moon Zone. There's Egg Zone. The furthest I could get to is Egg Rocket Zone. Turned out there was a Cosmic Angel Zone. Like, there's a lot of boards in this game. Then there's Knights boards. There's Samba de Amigo. There might be more than that. I haven't seen everything in this game, clearly. So I like that there's just a lot going on in this game. And I guess the one thing I don't like about it is the story mode. It could have been better. I like the tournament idea that it had going, but considering all the names that they threw on the little tournament board, like, there was Shadow, there was all the Jet Set Radio characters, like Beat, there's I might be wrong about that, but I think Beat was there. There's a bunch of characters from Sega in general. Like, I think there was some Phantasy Star characters. But at the end of the day, like, for the story mode, we got, like, Knuckles, we got Amy, and we got Tails. Like, that was, like, the 3, I think, and then Metal Sonic. I feel like they could have done more with the character choices for this tournament thing. That's really all I gotta say about it. And then, it's very unfair. Like, once you get to Eggman or Metal Sonic, whatever it was, Like, at some point, you have to average, like, 20,000 points, like, every 3 seconds or something. It was kind of ridiculous. Took me a lot of tries to beat it. Very difficult game, let's just say that. But, yeah. Sonic Rush. Believe it or not, my opinions on this game have like, changed so much. Like, when I first played this game as a kid, I really didn't like it. Like, like, I don't know what it was. Like, it's just a game I beat by the end of the night that I bought it. And then I was really mad about that for some reason. Like, I didn't think I got my money's worth with it or something. And then for a long time, I was really positive about it. Like, I came back to it. I really liked it. Like, I like zones. I like zones here and there. I like Dead End. I like Huge Crisis. I like Water Palace. Like, I like the ideas of them. I like the soundtrack, obviously. I love Blaze. Y'all know that. But the actual game, like, coming back to it again, like, I rebought it because I keep losing fucking copies of it. I probably own 4 copies of this game, believe it or not. But this one right here, when I came back to it, it felt surprisingly cheap. Like, it felt like the gameplay just, I wasn't really feeling how it controlled and stuff. Like, it felt like a fucking mobile game or something. I don't know what it felt like, but it didn't play as well as I remember it playing. Let's just say that. And, it's just unfortunate. Like, it's a good game, but for me, it didn't age as well as I thought it did. But yeah, Rush Adventure, I think it's an improvement in every single way of the original game. I don't know what's the opinion on it, but yeah, I think this game is pretty cool. Again, like, it feels basically like Rush did, so I don't really particularly care too much how it feels and stuff, but I do like that there's a lot more added to it. There's an original, like, boss and stuff. There's new zones. Like, we're in Blaze's world, so, like, everything's kind of like, I like that they flipped it around. Like, now we're in Blaze's world, so things kind of get a little weird and stuff with the ideas and whatnot. One of my favorite things, though, is that there's mini games. Like, there's, like, a travel system and stuff. Kind of adds more replayability to the game, and I like that about it. Like, it feels more like a complete game as far as Rush is. Like, Rush feels complete, but it's missing something. I don't know what it was, but Rush Adventure gave it to me. Let's just say that. The Rivals games aged like shit for me. Like, the only thing I really like about these games is, like, the actual zones. Like, if you like Sonic Heroes, you'll probably like these games. Like, because they kind of take upon ideas from Heroes. Like, there's that Bingo stage. Forget the name of it. Like, I know it's Bingo Highway in, it's Bingo Highway on Heroes, but then it's something else on there. Like, it might be like Neon Street or some shit, I forget. But there's, like, the bingo thing in that game. For what it was, like, I don't know why I thought it would be like a Sonic Riders on the go. So that's what I kind of expected it to be. I wish it was, but for what it is, it's a pretty cool little PSP game. I don't really recommend going out and buy a PSP just to play these. But they're okay for what they are. Like, it has Sonic voice acting in it. It has an actual storyline. It has original stages. It has some positives, but for me, it's just like Rush. Like, I don't think these games really age too well for me. But for one thing, let me just say, like, all these handheld games, like, I know them for what they are. I don't really knock them for playing how they play and stuff. So, it is what it is. Like, they're made for what they do what they're supposed to do. They're not supposed to feel like console games and stuff, so I don't really get on them for that. Okay, so Shadow the Hedgehog. We haven't really talked too much about Shadow the Hedgehog. It has its positives, it has its negatives, but my biggest positive is that it continues the SA2 storyline a bit. Like, it plays upon things that we didn't know we wanted to hear about. Like, I don't know, like, Maria and Gerald Robotnik, more of the gun. So it is, like, as much as, like, it bastardizes a lot of what SA2 bought, it did continue that. Like, I would have much rather that than what the fuck we have now with the Wisp and all this nonsense. Like, I'd take that 5 more times, you know, like, them bastardizing, like, what the adventure games were doing. So yeah, like, I like that they do bring that back. Like, there's a lot of these stages reimagined. Like, the I remember I forget the name of the stages, but for sure they brought back Metal Harbor, like Prison Island. Just it's just destroyed because it got blown up. So we get to see what Prison Island looks like after, like, the aftermath. And it's just, like, it's kind of sadistic, but it's kind of cool at the same time, you know? Same with some other stages. Like, there was the Ark. Like, I know that was one of the stages with Maria. Yeah, it's just really cool that we get to see a lot of these enemies come back. A lot of our friends come back. And it's just a cool reimagining of a lot of these, like, SA2 areas and stuff, you know? Just a what if after that, you know? Really cool. The bad things are pretty obvious. I'm like most people. I don't really care for how fucking edgy it is. Like, the guns are okay. I'm not, surprisingly, I don't really hate the guns. Like, they're all really cool. I don't really care for the missions, like, different things. Like, if it were up to me, you just go to the end of every stage. Like, what is it? There's probably like 40 stages in the game. Like, I would just straight to the end, like, find the end ring. And I think just about every stage has one where you just, there's a neutral thing where you just find the end of the stage. And if I did an LP of that game, it would have been just like that. Like, it just been to the end of the stages. So, yeah. That's pretty much that. Like, I really like the Super Shadow ending a lot. Like, I'm a big Super Shadow fan. Like, just the design of it. And it was cool that he came back. Granted, it could have been cooler if it just stayed in SA2. Like, it had been that one time that we had it. Same with those six. Like, it would have been cool if that, like, it wasn't there. But, you know, it is what it is. But he looks pretty cool in this one, too. Like, it's just cool. Like, we get to see Super Shadow. Like, he's the main hero or whatever. And, yeah. Alright, so we did Sonic 06. Like, we talked a bit about that game. It's pretty obvious what I think. We're gonna jump into Sonic Unleashed. Now, Sonic Unleashed, man, look. This is an important part of this review, like, thing, just because Sonic Unleashed, I have to say, I respect it, but I don't like it. Let's just say that. I respect it, but I don't like it. And I say that because Sonic Unleashed does a lot of stupid shit. For me, my biggest complaint is the pacing of this game. You'll be enjoying it. You'll be going through some stages. Like, I feel like the pace, like, for what it does a lot of good things at one time, and then it'll just take it all away from you. Feeling good. Like, I remember there was, like, what was that? Like, it was Chunan Night. Like that stage a lot. And then there's a boss. And then there's Rooftop Run Day. And then there's like a stupid fucking stage after that. Like, I think it's and then there's Cool Edge Night. Like, I like the game, and then it suddenly reminds me that nah, I don't think you really like that game that much. Like, it has its moments, don't get me wrong. Like, it's just the timing. Every single time, as soon as I'm enjoying the game, I find myself enjoying something about it, something stupid happens. You need more medals. You have a stupid fucking stage. You have to do act 3s and 4s now, like, that just have a stupid gimmick as the act. Like, it could have been a lot better for me, let's just say that. I do appreciate that it's a very grand game, of course. Very grand game. Like, it's the last Sonic game that really pushed the envelope, that challenged Mario, it challenged anything that's on the console. Something that Sonic did was, I think, in my opinion, I think he pretty much, it's like the GameCube is pretty much his console when I look back on it. Because Mario only had like one or two games on it, like actual games and then spinoffs. So Sonic just was throwing them out. He had spinoffs, he had collections. I always think of Sonic as the GameCube being more of Sonic's console. And that's kind of what I wish going into that next-gen Sonic would have been. And it really was. Like, they didn't do enough. Like, they put out games, but they're all trash. And like, this game just reminds me, like, is that last game to challenge Nintendo, to challenge Sony, Microsoft, whoever. And it just did a lot of things presentation wise I like everything about the game until I have to play it. Let's just leave it at that. And I really do like, believe it or not, I like more of the night stages than day stages. I find Chunan Night, Dragon Road Night, I think it's called, to be one of my favorite stages. I really like Rooftop Run Night. I like Eggman Land a lot. Like, I like those kind of stages over the day stages. I don't know. Yeah. Secret Rings, trash. Black Knight basically did what Secret Rings did, but a lot better. I do think it's cool that Sonic, that these storybook games, like, for what they are, I wish that they were basically controller games, like you can play them with a controller. I'd like them a lot more. But yeah, my favorite thing about these games is that they take themes from, what's the word? Like, there's a medieval thing, there's the, like, they just take, like, fantasy, like, storybook ideas, and, you know, I wanted to see more of that. Like, I really would have liked to see more of it. But yeah. And we move on into Sonic Colors. Now, Sonic Colors, look, man, Sonic Colors, pretty boring game, let's be honest. Like, you do the Act 1s, you don't, like, after, like, all the Act 1s are fucking dope. If every act was like Act 1, or was just purely 3D for the most part, you felt really good about coming into these new stages. They introduced like a new gimmick, and then that's pretty much it. Then it goes to 2D. You might get a 3D section here and there, but for the most part, like, it's a boring fucking game to me. Like, I don't know, like, this is for a lot of people the beginning of the quality falling in Sonic, like, again, like, as far as the main title goes, not like a spinoff or anything. Like, a lot of people felt like Sonic kind of fell off here as far as quality goes. Now, it was a really high scored game, and I think it was mainly because it was just a super safe, like, a lot of 2D, basically a game that catered to Nintendo fans and Mario fans. Like, Sonic was never like super colorful and kiddie like that, besides like the classics up until that point. And had, like, I don't know, like, pop music and stuff in it. Not like Michael Jackson kind of pop, but like that cash kind of pop, you know. But overall, like, I'm cool with this game. I'd give it like a solid 7 maybe. It's probably like after Generations, it's probably the best modern game. Let me just say that. Like, I guess if there's one big complaint, why was there no Super Sonic ending? It began that era of no Super Sonic endings. Not counting Generations, because I don't even think that's canon. But yeah, it started that era of no Super Sonic, like, no Super Sonic endings. Like, it gave you, like, that stupid Eggman boss fight at the end of these games. Like, the one that was in Lost World as well. Like, it's the same exact boss and shit. Feels really fucking lazy. Like, I don't know, dude. Not fucking with it. Sonic Generations. Now, this game is not canon, so I don't really acknowledge this game too much, but pretty solid game. If anything, like, I feel like for what it is, a lot of missed opportunities, of course, with DLC. Instead, we get the fans making all these stages for free. I feel like something like Generations could have easily just been what they did up until Sonic Forces or whatever they decide to do after. Generations, like, Lost World could have not existed. We each could have got Generations DLC for a very long time, because look, Xenoverse 2, I can't think of anything else right now, but Xenoverse 2 is a big one where they're just living off DLC for a long time. GTA 5, like, all these games are just doing DLC like for a good ass time, like, good ass while before they do another game. And that's kind of what I wish Generations would have done. Like, just focused on doing that. Like, just DLC for about 4 or 5 years. Like, that would have been fine. Like, they'd have made more money than they made for Lost World. Let's just say that, you know. Now, I did LP Lost World, and I gave my thoughts on it at the time, and they were surprisingly really positive, like, at that time. I remember it being a super positive review. But it's a pretty mediocre game. Let's just leave it at that. Like, everything about it is mediocre. Like, they don't do anything offensive. They don't, the bosses are not, like, edgy. They're not, like, I don't know. It's just a really fucking safe game. I really don't care for its existence. But the cool thing about it is that it's as Sonic Extreme as we're gonna get. If there's anything I wish Sonic Lost World was, is that it was named Sonic Extreme. So that it would have just, you know, had the game live on in some kind of way. All right, and finally, Sonic Forces. Now, look, I know I'm going against my own logic here. I know I'm not supposed to be covering games I've already reviewed before, but I'd like to talk about this game one more time, really quickly. Now, for the most part, my review still stands. Like, everything about it is pretty much the exact same. Go watch that if you haven't already. But I've been playing a lot of Xenoverse 2 here and there, and it just made me feel like there's missed opportunities. Like, the whole idea of OCs in that game, maybe, like, we could have did something a bit deeper with bringing OCs. Because this is going to be, like, the OC game, right? Like, I don't know if Sega's going to do that again. But, yeah, I would, like, just the idea of being able to be on a hub world and interact with other people's OCs, do missions with each other, do races or something like that. I don't really know. But I feel like that's just a good base, like a good starting point. It's just having a hub world, being able to interact with Sonic and his friends and do missions from them. And yeah, like I feel like that was just a missed opportunity, being as linear and like as it is, like what the game is. And that's pretty much it for this video right here, man. I don't really want to talk about the rest of these, like the Sonic Racing games, Sonic Riders. Like, I don't know. I've already OP'd some of this stuff. Cool thing about Sonic Transformed was that I consider it like my year I came to Sonic YouTube and started this stuff. Like, it was a really positive time to be here. Like, Lost World wasn't out yet. So it was cool to see myself leave on that note. Like, I came here on a Sonic Racing game and I'm leaving on a Sonic Racing game, which is Team Sonic Racing. So I guess for me, like, that's personally kind of cool. But that's pretty much it for this video right here. Like, those were the other games I wanted to cover in some kind of fashion, like an LP or anything like that. Like, if you didn't see a game listed here, I probably LP'd it or something. And I recommend going check it out if you're curious of what I think of those games. And with that, I'm officially done, y'all. I can sit back here and relax. Just let y'all do y'all thing. Let this new generation of channels take over. It's y'all's. But I do want to ask a question. Why are you here? What made you a fan of Sonic? Is that reason why you're still here? Or is it something else? Doesn't seem like too many people are happy here with Sonic. Maybe besides like 6-year-olds and shit, but I mean, most of us were in our 20s. Doesn't seem like we're happy at all with Sonic, but we're here, you know. And I ask, why are you here? Maybe you want to hear what other people think of your favorite games. I don't know. Maybe it's not that, since we've been listening to each other's opinions for quite some time. Maybe you're here from some sort of personal gain, you know, maybe to get yourself out there, you know, use this as some sort of platform for a career, make some money. I don't know. Maybe you're afraid to just go back to being no one in real life, you know. Maybe we're afraid to start over. You know, some of us are unhappy with Sonic, but we stay because we like the status. We like having followers that listen to us talk about Sonic, and sometimes they'll listen to us talk about other shit on our mind. So maybe we like that, and we're just kind of keeping ourselves here because we're just afraid to start fresh. I don't know, man. I'm just ranting. In order for us to put out our best work here, we have to detach ourselves from Sonic. And that means being creative. Doing this shit with doing news videos and shit like that, discussion videos. We can do better than that. It's easy to just be the super happy about anything Sega does and get subs and views from it, you know. I could easily do that. I did it for a couple years. I didn't truly enjoy this stuff, and seems like a lot of y'all didn't either. Y'all didn't truly enjoy the stuff until I became 100% with my channel. And for that, I leave a Sonic legend. Thank y'all.